Hi friends, good to see you again. It's Pastor Bill, and you might remember my friend, Bill. This summer at Vacation Bible School, we learned some songs together, and now in Sunday school, we're gonna learn some more. This is a good one to help start our day. It's called, "This is the Day the Lord Has Made." The words are easy, they go like this. Just follow along with Bill. This is the day, that the Lord has made, that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice, let us rejoice, and be glad in it, and be glad in it. And that repeats. This is the day that the Lord has made, this is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day, this is the day, this is the day that the Lord has made. Now, parts of that we do repeating back and forth like we just did. Other parts we sing all together. And it's kind of hard to explain. It's much easier just to sing it. So we're going to sing it through a few times. You follow along with Bill, and I'll lead and play the guitar. I think that'll work. Let's give it a try.
This is the day. This is the day that the Lord has made, that the Lord has made. This is the day, this is the day that the Lord has made, that the Lord has made. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in the day, this is the day that the Lord has made.
That's all there is to it. A little bit of back and forth, but the words are simple. So let's try it one more time. Here we go.
This is the day, this is the day that the Lord has made, that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice. Let us rejoice
and be glad in it,
and be glad in it.
All together now.
This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day, this is the day that the Lord has made.
All right, we have lots of good things planned for you in Sunday school. So you go and have a good time, and we'll check back in with you later. Bye-bye.
Well, hello, my friends. How are you today? Hello, this is my friend Pedro. Welcome to RallyDay. How are you doing today, Pedro?
I am wonderful. Thank you so much for inviting me, Ahmed. I am so happy to be here with you and all of you.
Oh, I have missed my friends so much. I said, oh no, we have to celebrate coming back together again like we are family. So this day is called Rally Day, and we welcome people home, and we welcome people back to school and back to things that we love to do together. Right now, I want to introduce you to a very special friend, Pedro. This person is going to read us a story.
A story?
You like stories?
I love stories.
Okay, Miss Claire is going to read us a story. Ready?
Ready.
Okay.
Welcome to Sunday School. This is a different place for us meeting, but I wanted to make you feel welcome. This is my library. I love my library because it has lots of books. I really like children's books. So I thought that you might play along with me and enjoy Froggy Goes to School as a way to open up Sunday School this year. Okay. It was the first day of school. Froggy woke up and looked out the window. The sun was high in the sky. Oh no, the bus, I'll miss the bus. He hopped out of bed, flopped outside. The school bus was leaving. "Wait, wait," he yelled. The bus came to a stop, and the front door opened, and Froggy flopped up the steps. But when he reached the top step, everyone laughed and pointed their fingers at him. "Froggy!" yelled his friend Max. "What? Did you forget something?" Froggy looked down. Oops! Froggy was in his underwear. He dashed to the back of the bus and hid behind Max's umbrella all the way to school. At school, he hopped behind bushes. He tried to hide behind the flagpole. He rolled down the hall like a bowling ball. And in class, he pretended to be a flower pot. "Froggy!" yelled his teacher. "What?" But it wasn't his teacher. It was his father. Froggy rubbed his eyes. He had been dreaming. He was still in bed. "Rise and shine, Froggy. It's the first day of school," said his father. This time, Froggy got all dressed, and then he flopped into the kitchen. He tried to pour milk on his bowl of flies, but the carton flew out of his hands. "You're just nervous about school, Froggy," said his mother. "Everybody is the first day." "Not me," said Froggy. And together they leaped Frog all the way to the bus stop. At school, Froggy found his name tag on his table. He liked his name. It was the first word he knew how to read. It was the only word that he really knew how to read. He read it aloud. "Froggy," he said with pride. "Froggy?" cried his teacher, Miss Witherspoon. "What?" "Hush, dear. It's time to pay attention." Oh, but it wasn't easy to pay attention. He looked out the window and saw the leaves falling, and he felt like a leaf falling. Plop! He fell out of his chair. "Oops! Kindly stay in your chair, Froggy," said Miss Witherspoon. "We'll sit on the floor for circle time." At circle time, Miss Witherspoon said, "Now, children, today I'd like you to tell us what you did this summer." When Froggy's turn came, he jumped up and said, "This summer, I learned how to swim." And then he sang, "Bubble, bubble, toot, toot, chicken, airplane, soldier." Everybody jumped up and joined in. "Bubble, bubble, toot, toot, chicken, airplane, soldier." "Maybe you'd like to do that." In walked the principal, Mr. Mugwort. "Bubble, bubble, oops," said Froggy, looking more red in the face than green. Mr. Mugwort glared at him. Then he joined in. "Bubble, bubble, toot, toot, chicken, airplane, soldier," till the bell rang for recess. When Froggy flopped off the bus after school, his father said, "Froggy, how was your day at school?" "Great," said Froggy. "I taught the principal how to swim." "That's nice," said his mother. "But where's your lunchbox and your baseball cap?" "Oops, I left them at school." "Oh, Froggy, will you ever learn?" said his mother. "That's why I'm going to school, Mom." And together they leapfrogged all the way home. I hope you enjoyed that. I did. It made me remember some days when I was enjoying the first day of school. And yeah, you get a little nervous sometimes, but I want you to know that you need to relax and know that God cares about you, especially on your first day at school. I just wanted you to know that Jesus loves you and knows that you are so important, feels you are so important, and so do I. And I want you to have a good week, And we'll see you next time.
Pero,
I see.
I have to tell you and all my friends there. I have something so exciting.
Exciting?
Do you like magic?
I love magic.
Oh, we are going to do magic. We are going to learn a trick.
Oh, what kind of trick? Please tell me.
It's going to use cards.
Cards?
Yes. You have cards?
I don't have cards.
Okay, wait a minute and go get them.
Okay, give me one moment, please.
Okay.
Ahmed?
Yes?
I have cards.
Okay, all right. Then I tell you what we do next. Mr. David is going to tell us how to do a magic trick with cards. Ready?
I am ready.
Good to see you on RallyDay. Oh, it's good to see you. It's been so long. Becky and I really miss you guys. Well, we look forward to seeing you in the future. So I'm going to perform a little magic trick for you. And it sort of comes in the form of sort of a card trick and sort of a parable, okay? So, well, let me get started, okay? So, just pick a card, any card, any card. Oh, I guess that doesn't really work in this format. Okay, well, let's do it this way, okay? We have the family of Christians here with God as one of us in our family of God. And then we've got 16 just in different cards. Just, and these represent God and us, his family. Can you tell which one is God? Okay, you might think the ace, the high one. But actually, Jesus, the J, took on the form of a servant, the lowest, in order to serve us and redeem us. And so that's him. And this is parable is about the importance of keep looking up and keep your face up and looking up as we go through these difficult times. So this represents the world and the chaos and the confusion that is out there. But we are going to insert ourselves into this world and we're going to keep looking up. And by the way, this card trick is really best done if you duplicate it at home. So we'll pause in just a second and you can go get a deck of cards and get the ace, king, queen, and jack of hearts out. And then 16 in different cards, okay, whatever you want. So four here, 16 there, total of 20 cards. We'll pause here and just wait for you. Go get your cards. Okay, hopefully you're back and you've gotten your cards in front of you. Ace, king, queen, and jack, and 16 in different cards here. And we're just going to take us, the family of Christians, and we're going to scatter ourselves through this messy world. Okay, if two happen to end up together somewhere, they're going to get scattered around pretty well here in just a second. So those four are in here somewhere looking up. And it's important that they stay and continue to keep looking up during these difficult times. Okay, but we're going to shuffle them, which is not easy, but we'll shuffle this little deck. Now, every one of our decks is different. Yours at home is different than mine here. And we're going to count off 10 cards here, just like this. So I'll do it, and then you do it, okay? Okay, so 10 cards there, 10 cards there. Now you get to make a choice. We're going to turn one of these decks over, okay? One of these stacks of 10 over. Make sure choice as to which one you want to do. I'm going to turn this one over. Okay, so some of the family is going upside down, face down. Oh, some of the others now face up. That's sort of a mess, okay? And now we're going to do, so to speak, a perfect shuffle. I'm going to take one from my left over here and put it in the middle. You do the same thing. And then one from the right. And then one from the left and one from the right. Left, right. And you do it too until we get all the way through. A perfect shuffle and a perfect mess. Okay. Now at this point, we're going to cut our cards. You can do a little cut, a shallow cut, a deep cut, or a big cut. Okay, I'm going to do sort of a medium one over there. and then put this on top. Well, at least one of us is still looking up. I guess that would be Pastor Bill, the king. Okay, and now we're going to be dealing kind of like four hands of poker, because this seems, in these crazy times, it seems like everything's a gamble, okay? So, one, two, three, four. Just like you would normally deal at. Okay, and you'll notice that you and your partner are sort of across from each other, and choose one, either you or your partner, and put yours on top of your partner's or your partner's on top of yours. Don't turn them over or anything, just put one on top of the other, okay? That leaves two other piles, and choose one to put on top of the other. I'll choose this one. Now we're back with two stacks of cards. Once again, you get to make a choice. You're going to turn one of these two piles over. This time I'm going to choose this one and turn it over. And now we're also going to shuffle, okay, as best we can. Doesn't matter if it's perfectly good shuffled. And we'll push them all together back to one stack. Now put your left hand over that stack of cards, okay? And you, at this point, don't do what I do. You wait for me for a little bit and just keep your left hand there on top of your card, okay? So what we have here now is basically a perfect mess. You see, oh, luckily half the cards are upside down, right side up. Okay, and it's the same way, okay? But something amazing happens if you just have faith. Just have faith that everything's going to be okay. So I have my left hand over, and I'm going to take my right hand, and I'm going to exercise a little faith. Did you see it? Did you feel it? Okay, now watch what happens. Look, the only cards face up are the original Christian family. There's the king, and there's the queen, and there is the jack, and there's the queen, and the ace. Okay, now that wasn't too hard for me because I'm the magician and these are my cards in my hand. What's really curious is what happens in your cards in your hand. So your left hand is still over. And now snap, and now spread out the cards. It's possible that they'll all be face up, except only four will be face down, these. Or it may be that all of the other cards are face down and only these four cards are face up. Either way, we're reunited as our Christian family, as we will be someday when this whole mess is over. Okay, well, I hope you enjoyed this. Happy Rally Day, and I'll see you when we all get together. We love you. Becky and I love you, and we miss you. Bye.
What just happened? Did you see that?
I do not believe what I just did, Ahmed.
I know my eyes are explosions.
Explosions.
Explosions is so exciting. Very, very nice.
And so fun too.
Oh, I know. I love it. Okay, we are having fun?
See.
Okay, all right. I have to tell you the next thing. The next thing is we are going to learn something very special. We are going to learn how we welcome people into our homes. How do you welcome people into your home, Pedro?
Well, in my home where we come from, in Panama, we welcome people with special drinks, special food, and we make them feel part of our familia.
Oh, okay. In Egypt, we say, come in, my friend. Come sit down, have some tea, some drinks. It sounds very familiar.
It's very similar.
Okay, I think some of our friends are also going to have very similar things to tell us about welcoming people into the house.
That sounds wonderful.
Okay, see you later.
Bye-bye.
Hi, RLC.
Hello.
From the Marmaleos home, we wanted to send a short video and let you know how we like to welcome our friends and family into our home. Charlie and I really like to have big backyard barbecues, and unfortunately, Right now with COVID, we're not able to do that. But when we do, we always like to have a lot of friends over. Charlie really likes to smoke meat, so we always have a brisket, our ribs, our tacos. We always have everybody's favorite beverage from adult to children, and we always want to make everybody feel like they're just at home.
Yeah, Susie adds a lot of ambiance by decorating, whether it's for a holiday or even just celebrating the festivities. So it just makes it even that much more welcoming to when people come into our home, and it kind of goes on with whatever we're celebrating at the time. So, and then Avery loves to host her friends.
We like to play together and draw pictures and maybe like play tag and hide and go seek and do lots of fun things.
So those are the things that we like to do when we have friends and family over, and we can't wait to hear what you like to do when you have your friends and family over. We're hoping everybody is staying safe and healthy, and we hope we get to see each other soon.
So be safe, RLC.
I just want to be a sheep. Ah, I just want to be a sheep. Ah, oh Lord, my soul to keep. I just want to be a sheep.
Hello, my name is Kenneth Gather. I'm in Austin, Texas right now, so I can't show you my house. If I were to invite you in my home, I would probably ask you if you wanted to play video games with me, and we'd do all sorts of crazy stuff together.
Jesus loves me, this I know. For the Bible tells me so. Little one to him belong. They are weak, but he is strong.
And I'm planning to go back to Dallas tomorrow. I'm going to play a song for you. Hope you have a great day.
Hi everyone, this is Amy Drymiller, and I want to welcome you to my home. I look forward to seeing you this fall when I'm going to be helping with the arts and crafts at Resurrection Lutheran Church, the Sunday School, for this virtual learning that we're going to be doing this fall, and then hopefully through the year when we start meeting in person. I hope to see you soon.
Friends, bye. I am so excited to see you. I haven't seen you in so long. I miss you so much, and I really, 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 really hope I get to see you soon. But in the meantime, I want to tell you about how I welcome people into my home. Well, I like to make sure that my home is very, very clean, and my husband and my son Ben, they get really angry at me because I'm like, clean your room, help me take out the trash, help me vacuum, help me get this place dusted and nice and neat. And everybody's working very hard because we're all getting ready for a visitor. Now, the next thing I do is I prepare special foods. I am from the Northeast, which is way up north and over a little ways and right by the ocean. And right by the ocean, we eat a lot of crabs. And so one of my favorite things to do is to make crab dip. And I get it all ready, and it is my son's favorite, and he tries to eat it before the guests come. And I say, don't you touch it. It's not for you. It's for our guests. It's something special. And then I make some other foods that my husband really likes, and I find him in there trying to eat it too. And I'm like, you guys stop. And then I get special drinks that maybe we don't have all the time. And my family gets very excited because we're like about to eat some really special things and do some special things. And then our guests come and we say, come on in, welcome. I can't wait to see you. Oh, thank you for coming to our home. Thank you. Come on in, have a seat. Here, why don't you sit in this special chair and why don't you sit over here? And guess what? I just made some really yummy food and I'm gonna put it out on the table and you guys are welcome to help yourself. Can I pour you something to drink? This is what we have. Now, you know Miss Betsy's favorite is a good Diet Coke with lots of ice and a lemon. But not everybody likes that. So we have a variety. We have water, we have tea, we have special tea, we have maybe some juice, and we go all out. It's really exciting. And then I sit down and I kind of talk to people. I say, well, what did you do this summer? How was your summer? How was graduation? It depends what time of year it is. But I kind of try to ask about them because I want to know exactly what is going on in their lives. Because I want to be as much a part of them as they are a part of me. Now, I grew up very far away from here. I grew up in a place called Africa. And in Africa, there's a country called Egypt. And Egypt is a very north part of Africa. And one of the things that they do when they invite people into their home is they say, come on in and bring all of God's blessings that He has bestowed upon your family into my home so that I can be doubly blessed. And so you're not just welcoming your friends, but you're welcoming all the things that God has blessed them with into your home. And so now your home is filled with people that you love and care for, and it's filled with God's blessing. And God says, you know, where two or more are gathered in His name, I am present. And so we celebrate that in each other. We celebrate all the wonderful things that God has done in the lives of the people that visit our homes. And we say, thank you so much for allowing us to share in your blessings. And that's how we, at my home, welcome people into our home. Now, I know that so many of you have not been able to go to birthday parties or go to grandma's house or kind of get out and about and do things. Some of you are at home alone you're the only child and you haven't seen other kids in a while, and sometimes you get bored and it's hard to play all by yourself. Or some of you are so sick of your siblings taking all your toys and getting in your way. And then the other thing is, so many of you have been looking forward to going to school. Maybe you just started kindergarten, or maybe third grade, or maybe you've just started preschool, and it's so exciting. But it's so different than we normally do it. Some of you are getting to go to school, but it's not the same. And some of you are having to do school from home, and it's not the same. But guess what? We're doing it. We're still learning. Whether we're at home or whether we're at school, it's important to want to come together. It's important to want to gather, whether it's on videotape, whether it's on a Zoom, or whether it's on FaceTime, whatever it is. It's important for us to come together, because whether we're in the same space or whether we're in two different spaces, we're still family. We still come together and we still celebrate all the blessings that God has bestowed upon our lives, and we share them. And it makes us happy, and it makes our heart happy to see our friends and family again. And so I am going to be seeing you every week, and I'm going to have a little message for you, and I'm going to have other friends come in until we can actually see face to face. So I'm going to give you more instruction next week, but in the meantime, have a blessed week and have a great time, whether you're at school at home or whether you're at school in a building. I love you, we love you, and we miss you horribly. Bye-bye.
Hey, Pedro, wasn't that fun?
I had the time of my life.
Oh, I love the singing and the time of my life and the barking. I will see all you all next week when we have the best time once again, celebrating how we come together.
I'm so excited to learn more.
Okay, friends, I'm mailing you something. Be ready to see it in your mailbox. All right, see you next week.
See you next week, everybody. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.